The Jack Benny Program, transcribed and presented by Lucky Strike.
If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette. They taste fine. Tobacco, it's light. Tobacco, it's mild. Tobacco, too. And it's toasted, yes, it's toasted, because the toasting brings the flavor right through. So to get better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
This is Don Wilson, friends. There in words and music is the story of Lucky's better taste. It's toasted. A Lucky tastes better simply because it's the cigarette of fine tobacco and it's toasted to taste better. It's toasted. The famous Lucky Strike process brings Lucky's fine tobacco to its peak of flavor, tones up this light, mild, good-tasting tobacco to make it taste even better, cleaner, fresher, smoother. That's the Lucky Strike story, pure and simple. Remember that, friends, the next time you buy cigarettes, and make it a carton of better-tasting Lucky Strike.
If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
The Lucky Strike program starring Jack Benny with Mary Livingston, Rochester, Dennis Day, Bob Crosby, and yours truly, Don Wilson. Ladies and gentlemen, it isn't often that our star goes out on a personal appearance tour. But having decided to go, a lot of preparations have to be made. At the moment, Jack is in conference with his new publicity man, Dick Fisher.
Yes, sir, Benny, this is the greatest idea I ever had. You just listen to me and we'll pack every theater from the sun-kissed shores of California to the rock-bound coast of Maine.
But, Dick...
What an idea! Hand me that phone and I'll order the posters right now. We'll have billboards all over the country.
But, Dick, I've never been billed that way before. Jack Benny, the platinum ball of fire. I mean, it's ridiculous. I've never worked with fans or balloons.
I'm way ahead of you, Benny. Instead of fans or balloons, you'll come out in a blue spot and do your stuff with two violins.
What?
And at the end of the dance, the violins open and pigeons fly out.
Pigeons?
Certainly. You always get the bird. Let's bring our own.
Now, look, Dick, I told you last week when I hired you, I don't want any crazy stuff. All I want... Excuse me, there's someone at the door. What a silly idea. Jack Benny, the platinum ball of fire.
Hello, Jack.
Oh, hello, Mary. Come on in.
Where's Rochester?
That's what I'd like to know. Last night he asked me if he could have the evening off, and I haven't seen him since.
Well, Jack, maybe he... Dick! Dick Fisher!
Mary Livingston, long time no see.
Mary, you know Dick Fisher?
Well, certainly. He was my publicity man when I worked at the May Company.
No.
Yes, sir. I gave this little girl one of the most extensive publicity campaigns in my career. In 2 short weeks, I raised her from the bargain basement to the stocking counter on the 5th floor.
Well.
And this, mind you, during the heat of a presidential campaign.
All right, calm down. I don't doubt that you're a great publicity man. But you'll have to think up another stunt for me. I'm not going to go for those pigeons.
What's that supposed to be?
I don't know. Dick's got some idea about my personal appearance tour. He wants me to work with pigeons.
I think that's a great idea.
What are you laughing at?
I can just see the finale. A pigeon swoops down, takes off your toupee, and lays an egg in it.
Mary, this is going to be a high-class show, and I've got some wonderful dates lined up, haven't I, Dick?
That's right. On June 14th, Jack opens for 2 weeks at the Dallas State Fair Auditorium. Then on July 1st, he moves into the Public Auditorium in Portland, Oregon.
That's right, and on July 7th, I swing up to Canada to play the Georgia Auditorium in Vancouver.
And then, for a whirlwind finish, he winds up at the Metropolitan Theater in Seattle starting July 12th.
That's quite a schedule, Jack.
Yeah. Now, Dick, I wish we could think of a cute publicity angle for Dallas.
Don't worry, Benny. I got just the thing for you.
What is it?
When we arrive in town, I want you to walk from Dallas to Fort Worth playing your violin and lead 1,000 cows into the slaughterhouse.
Into the slaughterhouse? Well, how do you know the cows will follow me?
Follow you? They'll be pushing you.
Look, they won't be pushing me because I'm not going to play. Answer that, will you, Mary, please?
Hello? Mr. Benny's residence. Mary, the upstairs maid, talking.
Oh, don't be funny.
Hello, Mary. This is Charlie Bagby. Can I talk to the old man?
Just a minute. Jack, it's Charlie Bagby, your piano player.
Oh. Hello, Charlie.
Jack, I want to talk to you about the band arrangements on your personal appearance tour. Have you got a minute?
Sure, what is it?
How do you want us orchestra boys to dress? In blue suits or sport clothes?
Well, neither one, Charlie. I want you to wear evening clothes.
The only evening clothes we've got are pajamas. What? And we can't wear those. Half the drawstrings are missing.
Look, Charlie, wear whatever you want, but have Sammy the drummer in a blue suit, because he'll be sitting up high.
Okay.
And another thing, Charlie, when I'm out on the stage telling jokes, I want you boys to act as though you're enjoying it. You know, it looks good to the audience.
Don't worry. We'll take care of the people in the balcony, too. We'll paint a smile on the top of Sammy's head.
Oh, that'll be wonderful.
There's only one problem, and that's Remley.
Remley?
Yeah, but everything will be all right if we let him sit back on my piano.
But, Charlie, I want it to look like we've got a big orchestra. Why shouldn't Frankie sit out in the open?
Because every time a spotlight shines in his face, he jumps up and yells, "I didn't do it! I didn't do it!"
Look at Charlie. I'm busy. Look at, arrange the orchestra the best way you can. That's so long.
So long.
That orchestra is the craziest.
Benny, while you were on the phone, I got a sensational idea.
Huh?
Well, according to the schedule, you open July 1st in Portland, Oregon.
That's right. I'll be at the Public Auditorium.
Well, since July 1st happens to be the start of Fire Prevention Week, for a publicity stunt, we'll have you jump from the top of a 12-story building into a net. It's never been done before.
Dick, look, what do you mean it's never been done before? Many people have done stunts like that, jumping off of a building into a net.
A hairnet?
Okay, cut that out. I want my publicity simple and dignified. So you better... Well, now, who can that be? Come in.
Hello, Jack.
Hello, Mary.
Hello, Don.
Hello, Don.
Come on in, fellas.
Now, Don, I know you brought the boys over to try out the commercial, but I'm busy right now. Dick Fisher, my publicity man, is laying out my personal appearance tour. You know, I opened June 14th in Dallas.
Yes, I know. I was planning to be there.
You were?
Yeah, I thought I'd catch your act and also enter my prize steer in the livestock show.
Oh, that one you've been fattening up all year?
Yeah, but something unfortunate came up yesterday and I won't be able to show him.
What happened?
I got hungry.
But, Dad, how could you eat your prize steer?
With Tabasco sauce, it's delicious.
I can imagine. Well, Don, as I told you, I'm very busy with Dick Fisher right now, so why don't you and the boys come back another time?
But, Jack, wait a minute. This will just take a second. Now, the reason I want you to hear the commercial is because Lucky Strike has a new jingle they're introducing today on your program, and the sportsmen want to sing it.
A new jingle for the commercial? Oh, it's wonderful. Let me hear it, Don.
If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
They take fine tobacco. It's light tobacco. It's mild tobacco, too.
And it's toasted. Yes, it's toasted. Because the toasting brings the flavor right through. So to get better
better taste from your cigarette. Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette. Be happy-go-lucky. Tobacco that's toasted. It's toasted. It's toasted. It's toasted. If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
They take fine tobacco, it's light tobacco, it's mild tobacco too.
And it's toasted, yes, it's toasted, because the toasting brings the flavor right through. So to get better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette. It's toasted. A better tasting cigarette.
Hey, that was very good, Don, and the jingle is real catchy.
Oh, thanks, Jack. Well, I guess we better be running along. So long, Mary.
So long, Don. Bye, fellas.
Now, where were we, Dick? Is there any other idea you got for publicity?
Yes, sirree. I've been working on a Lulu for Seattle.
You have?
You know, that's great fish country, so I made a deal that on the day of your opening, you spend 6 hours in a fish cannery, then you go directly to the theater.
Wait a minute. If I go right from the fish cannery to the theater, won't I smell?
Yes, but I'm giving you a reason.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Dick. I'm not going to do any of those crazy things, so let's forget it.
Okay.
Oh, Jack.
What?
When you go out to buy a wardrobe for your stage show, I'd like to go with you.
Wardrobe?
Certainly. Aren't you going to buy some new suits?
Mary, I just bought a new suit. In fact, you were with me.
That was in 1936.
Gosh, how time flies. But maybe you're right. I should get a new suit. I'll answer the door.
Hello, Mr. Benny.
Oh, hello, Dennis.
Can I come in?
Well, I don't know. Will your dog bite me?
Oh, no. My dog wouldn't bite you.
Are you sure?
My dog wouldn't bite anybody.
Oh. Well, in that case, come on in. That's cute. Hi, puppy. Ouch! My leg! Dennis, you said your dog wouldn't bite me.
That isn't my dog.
What? That isn't your dog. Then what's he doing here?
I don't know. I was just walking down the street. He whistled at me, so I followed him.
Now, wait a minute. Don't be ridiculous. A dog can't whistle. That's amazing. That dog whistled young at heart.
Yesterday, he bit Sinatra.
Gee. You know, Dennis, I just thought of something. I could make a fortune if I could use that dog on my television show.
No, this dog would be all right on radio, but you can't use him on television.
Why not?
He photographs like a man.
Yeah, he does. Word for that mustache, he'd look like a Mexican hairless. Now, Dennis, I have to go out and buy some new clothes, so if you came over here to rehearse your song, let me hear it.
Okay.
And when you finish it, I want you to... Wait a minute, kid. Hold it.
What's the matter?
I just heard the back door open and close. Must be Rochester sneaking in. Oh, Rochester!
Yes, boss?
Come on in here. I want to talk to you.
Yes, sir.
Now, Rochester, last night you asked me if you could have the evening off, didn't you?
Uh-huh.
Now, that was last night. Now, it's 11 o'clock the next morning.
Uh-huh.
So where have you been?
Well, boss, I'm going on my vacation soon, and some friends of mine on Central Avenue gave me a farewell party.
Now, wait a minute, Rochester. Every night this week, you've been to a farewell party.
It's the same one. We just adjourned during the daytime.
Well, look, Rochester, I haven't got time to talk to you. I got to listen to Dennis sing his song. Let's have it, Dennis.
Seeking happiness, thrown by three hopeful lovers, which one will the fountain bless? Three hearts in the fountain, each heart longing for its home. There they lie in the fountain, somewhere in the heart of Rome. Which one will the fountain bless? Which one will the fountain bless? Three coins in the fountain, through the ripples how they shine. Just one wish will be granted, one heart will wear a valentine. Which one will the fountain bless? One heart will wear a valentine. Make it mine. Make it mine. Make it
was very good, Dennis. Your voice is in great shape.
I've got to go now. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Jack, if you want me to go downtown with you to pick out a suit, we better go now.
Okay, Mary.
Jack, why don't you keep your garage cleaner?
Oh, I'll straighten it up someday. Come on, get in the car. Go ahead, start the car, Rochester.
Yes, sir, but first I gotta get a little water.
Oh, is the radiator dry?
No, I'm taking an aspirin. I know what's coming.
Never mind that. Just start the car.
Yes, sir.
Rochester, what's wrong with the motor?
It ain't bad for a dog.
Well, try it again, will you?
Yes, sir.
Well, here we are, Mary. There's the store across the street. Rochester, there's a parking space.
Where?
Between that truck and that convertible.
But I can't get into that space. It's too small.
Well, put our bumper up against the truck and push it.
Oh, boss, calm down.
Well, look, Miss Livingston and I will get out here and you find a parking space.
Yes, sir.
Well, here's the store, Mary. Let's go in. Now, let's see. Where
Hiya,
is it?
Hiya, bud. What's new?
Huh? Oh, hello. Come on, Mary.
Who is that?
That's that racetrack tout I'm always running into. Well, let's see. I wonder where...
Oh, good afternoon. May I help you, sir?
Yes, yes. I'd like to buy a new suit.
I don't blame you.
What?
I'm Mr. Kearns, and I'll be glad to show you our new spring line.
Good, good. But first, tell me, what is the price range here?
Well, our suits start at $20 and go up to $150.
Well, I wouldn't want to wear anything as cheap as $20, and yet I wouldn't want to go way up to $150, you know.
I understand.
I like something in the middle, you know, say about $30.
Oh, Jack, why don't you get a good suit for a change? After all, you're going to wear it on the stage every night.
Stage? Are you an actor?
Well, yes, yes, I am. I'm Jack Benny. Now, Mr. Kearns, what color suit would you suggest that I get?
Well, a lot of men select a color to match their hair or their eyes. Let's see. Your eyes are blue, aren't they?
That has never been challenged.
Oh, Jack.
What is it, Mary?
Here's a very pretty suit. It's gabardine.
Oh, say, that looks good. I like gabardine.
I'm sure that suit would look very nice on you, Mr. Benny.
Yes, but it's $45.
Oh. There's a whistle in the pocket.
Oh, well, I don't care about that, but I think I'll take it.
Fine, fine. I'll go upstairs and get our tailor so he can measure you for any alterations.
Thank you. Say, Mary, I'm going to walk to the back of the store and see if there's anything else I'd like. Want to join me?
No, I'm tired. I'll sit right here.
Okay. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Yum, bum, 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 bum. Yep, that gabardine suit will look nice. $45, though. Oh, well. There's no...
Hey, piece. Bud. Bud.
Huh?
Come here a minute.
Who, me?
Yeah, yeah. What are you doing?
I'm buying a suit.
What kind?
Gabardine.
Uh-uh.
What?
Get a wool suit.
Well, why should I get wool?
On account of the pants. They're great in the back stretch.
Well, but I like gabardine.
Look, I'm telling you for your own good, get wool.
But...
Don't take my word for it. Look at the breeding.
The breeding?
Wool is out of Mary's Little Lamb by Bob Bob Black Sheep.
Well, look, I'm going to buy a gabardine suit, and that settles it.
Well, okay, it's your dough.
What a guy. Whenever I run into him, I...
Oh, there you are, Mr. Benny.
Yes, yes, I was just sort of looking around.
Well, I'd like you to meet our tailor, Mr. Benny. This is Mr. Nelson.
How do you do?
How do you do? Now, I don't want to seem impatient, but I'm in a hurry. Can we get on with the measuring?
Why, certainly. Mr. Nelson, do you have your tape measure with you?
Yes. Now, hold still, little man.
Little man?
You're buying the one with the whistle in the pocket, aren't you?
Look, Mr. Nelson, just take the measurements.
Very well. Collar, 16.
Collar, 16.
Shoulders, 18.
Shoulders, 18.
Chest. Well, how did it get way down there?
Look, never mind that.
Right sleeve, 34.
Right sleeve, 34.
Left sleeve, 21.
Left sleeve, 21.
Wait a minute. Why are you making the left sleeve so short?
Well, you want people to see your wristwatch, don't you?
No, and stop wasting my time. Now, Mr. Nelson, when will my suit be ready?
In 4 weeks.
4 weeks? But I want it for my personal appearance tour.
Well, I'm sorry. It'll take 4 weeks.
You mean I can't have my brand new suit for my opening in Dallas?
No, but if you like, we'll run an ad in the paper telling them you bought one.
You mean you're going to run an ad telling everybody I bought a new suit?
Well, when you bought that one you're wearing, it pushed Lindbergh right off the front page.
Well, I've had enough of this. I'm not going to buy the suit at all.
But, Jack, what are you going to do about your personal appearance in Dallas?
I'll show you. Let me use that phone. Fix this. Hello, Dick. Buy some corn. We're going to use those pigeons after all.
Jack will be back in just a minute, but first a word to cigarette smokers.
If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette. They taste fine. Tobacco, it's light. Tobacco, it's mild. Tobacco, too. And it's toasted, yes, it's toasted, because the toasting brings the flavor right through. So to get better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
Yes, friends, for a truly better tasting smoke, better light a Lucky Strike. It's toasted to taste better. Of course, Lucky's better taste begins with fine, naturally mild, good-tasting tobacco. LSMFT, Lucky Strike means fine tobacco. And then that tobacco is toasted. It's toasted. The famous Lucky Strike process tones up the tobacco to make it taste even better, cleaner, fresher, smoother. So for the better taste you want from your cigarette, be happy. Go Lucky. Buy a carton of Lucky Strike.
If you want better taste from your cigarette, Lucky Strike is the brand to get. It's toasted to give you the best taste yet. It's the toasted cigarette.
We're a little late, so good night, folks.
The Jack Benny program is written by Sam Perrin, Milt Josephsburg, George Balzer, John Tackerberry, Al Gordon, Al Goldman, and produced and transcribed by Hilliard Marks. The Jack Benny program is brought to you by Lucky Strike, product of the American Tobacco Company, America's leading manufacturer of cigarettes.
This is the CBS Radio Network.
Are you itching for a good story? Laughter among friends? Maybe a mystery? Fire Breathing Kittens is a standalone Dungeons and Dragons podcast. Each episode is a separate 3-hour long story, like a movie for your ears. You can listen to these adventures in any order. Join us on an actual play D&D quest as we solve mysteries, attempt comedic banter, and enjoy friendship. Fire Breathing Kittens Podcast. Fantasy, action, mystery, and friendship.